Over and over again, we see children trick-or-treating near a registered sex offender's home. That's what we saw tonight, but a U.S. Marshal right there as well. ABC 15's John Erickson is live, and John, there are special rules tonight.
Steve, authorities say something as simple as this: a jack-o'-lantern isn't allowed outside a registered sex offender's home on Halloween. That's because police don't want children to come knocking at the door.
He's dressed as a police officer going door to door this Halloween night. But if he finds anyone handing out candy, it's a problem, because the doors he's knocking on are the doors of sex offenders.
One of the things that we do is make sure that all the lights are out so that they don't attract any of the children. There won't be any candy out, no decorations.
Dozens of officers around the valley tonight.
We want to make sure that the kids are safe and are as far away as they can be from these individuals tonight.
And open the door! Come to the door!
Officers were trying to find someone at this house as young trick-or-treaters marched closer. The neighborhood, a case of opposites. Dark, except for the officers' flashlights on one side of the street, a Halloween party on the other. Same case at a different home. Decorations here, next door, dark and uninviting. And that's the idea.
They were going after the individuals that have been convicted of a child sex crime is who we're actually going for tonight.
Halloween can stay scary in the movies, but the goal for these officers is to keep it safe in real life.
So on our ride along, no arrests tonight. Those registered sex offenders mostly doing what they're supposed to be doing as far as these rules go, guys.